गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द क्लासेस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द 8th चैप्टर दैट इज रेस्पिरेशन एंड सर्कुलेशन. सो विच इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट लाइफ प्रोसेस एंड इट हैज गुड मार्क्स. सो बाय डूइंग दिस चैप्टर यू मे स्कोर द मोर मार्क्स. एंड बिफोर आई स्टार्ट दिस लेसन वन थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू से यू दैट. So whenever you are watching this video lectures, at that time you need to be take the textbook front of you, and while watching you have to be observe the things in the textbook. So what are the things we are teaching here? So I want to say you that we are going to teach word by word, so that you need to be check out there, so you may understand it well. So it is very difficult to learn the lessons from the YouTube videos. So many videos are there, so many digital videos are there, but reality won't be come there. Reality is different and watching video is different. So you have to while watching the videos you need to be take textbook front of you, then only you will be understand better. So first of all we'll take this respiration and circulation 8th chapter, so which has good weightage to do it well properly. So, what is respiration? ये respiration क्या है? Respiration किसको बोलते हैं? Since from the beginning you are learning it. Respiration means what? What is respiration? Respiration क्या है? किसे respiration कहते हैं? Respiration most probably the definition will be give taking air inside and leaving air outside. And inhalation and exhalation is called as the respiration. So inhalation and exhalation is the only one part of the respiration. It is not complete definition of the respiration. So as you have grown up now, so you need to be give the scientific definition of the respiration which have been given in our board textbook. So that is respiration is the biochemical process. So what kind of process it is? Ye kaisa process hai? It is the biochemical process. Bio means what here? Bio. Bio in the sense life. Chemical process है. The process जो है वो chemical ही हो जाती है, लेकिन किस में होती है? Cell के अंदर होती है. Cell कैसे है? Cell को life है. So biochemical process. Process किसे कहते हैं? It never stops. Process in the sense the things which is happening that never get stops. That is called process. Respiration never stops. So it is a biochemical process of oxidation. Oxidation means what? You might be learned in the oxidation reduction in the chemistry. Oxygen in the sense addition of oxygen and removal of hydrogen is called oxidation. So here O2 will be added, oxygen will be added, and for the process of respiration we know that oxygen is required, oxidation is required. So it is a biochemical process of oxidation of क्या ऑक्सीडेशन होता है इधर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. कौन से ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स है? द फूड विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द सेल विच इज स्टोर्ड इन द सेल दैट इज इन अनयूजेबल फॉर्म ऑफ फूड इज कॉल्ड द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. ये ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड कौन से हो सकते हैं? इट मे बी द कार्बोहाइड्रेट, इट मे बी द प्रोटीन, इट मे बी द लिपिड्स. कौन से भी न्यूट्रिएंट हो सकते हैं उसको क्या कहते हैं? ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. ऑक्सीडेशन किसका होने जा रहा है? ये ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड का. किसके साथ? कौन ऐड हो रहा है इधर? ऑक्सीजन ऐड हो रहा है. तो इन एन ऑर्डरली मैनर हाउ इट विल बी ऑकर्स एट ए टाइम डोंट टॉक. इट विल बी ऑकर्स बाय द स्टेप वाइज मैनर, स्टेप बाय स्टेप. द एनर्जी विल बी रिलीज्ड इन टू द स्टेप वाइज मैनर. एट ए टाइम द एनर्जी वोंट रिलीज हियर. Stepwise manner energy will be released. So it will be occurs by the orderly manner, and for the liberation of chemical energy. यहाँ पर क्या liberate होने जा रहा है? Energy liberate होने वाली है. कौन सी energy? Chemical energy will be get liberated in the form of ATP. कौन से form में release हो जाएगी? ATP के form में release हो जाएगी. So इसी को respiration कहते हैं. It is a biochemical process. You need to be learn this. ये आपको definition याद करना है. It is a biochemical process of the oxidation of the organic compounds in an orderly manner for the liberation of chemical energy in the form of a ATP. As we know that almost all the living organisms, they require the energy to perform life processes. Almost all living organisms, all organisms require energy for what? For the life processes. जो body में life process होते हैं उनके लिए क्या चाहिए? Energy चाहिए. इसके लिए all the living organisms energy is required. And this energy will be there in the body, but it is in unusable form. That energy is present in the unusable form. Energy is stored in an organism. कौन से फॉर्म में रहती है energy? For example, a person has taken enough diet, enough food he has taken, and that food will be get digested, and the food will be get absorbed. And the absorbed food materials along with the blood, it comes towards the each and every cell of our body. Each and every cell of our body. The carbohydrates we have taken, starch we have taken, the proteins we have taken, and lipids content we have taken, so that all will be get absorbed and it is stored into the cells. But the stored energy is called potential energy. The energy is present, but that is in the form of a potential energy. Potential energy is stored here. Stored energy is there. It has the power. Potential means power. It has power, but that is unusable form. So this unusable form of energy will be converted into the usable form of energy. पोटेंशियल एग्जाम्पल, पोटेंशियल एनर्जी का एक एग्जाम्पल है. सपोज वन प्लांट इज देयर एंड इट हैज मैंगो ट्री इज देयर एंड दैट मैंगो ट्री हैज वन मैंगो दैट इज हैंगिंग. इट हैज द पावर, इट हैज न्यूट्रिएंट, बट इट इज नॉट वर्किंग. व्हेन इट इज अप, इट इज अनयूजेबल फॉर्म. एंड द सेम मैंगो व्हेन इट कम्स डाउन, दैट विल बी कम्स इनटू द यूजेबल फॉर्म. Potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy. So here also the energy is present by the process of digestion. The food will be present in each and every cell, but it is unusable form. That unusable form of food will be converted into usable form of energy. That food, of course, this food will be giving the energy to us. Carbohydrates will give energy to us, but when it gives energy, when the oxidation of food will be occurs. वो जब ऑक्सीडाइज होता है तभी एनर्जी क्या हो जाएगी? लिबरेट होती है. तो ये अनयूजेबल फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द यूजेबल फॉर्म. हु विल बी मेक इट पॉसिबल? द रेस्पिरेशन. अनयूजेबल एनर्जी विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द यूजेबल फॉर्म. हु विल बी मेक इट पॉसिबल? रेस्पिरेशन. द लाइफ प्रोसेस रेस्पिरेशन विल बी मेक इट पॉसिबल. Unusable will be converted into usable. अब unusable कौन सी है? Unusable means all the organic compounds. These all organic compounds. Organic compounds are present. Energy is there. Energy is stored, but it is in the unusable form. So it will be converted into the usable form. Which usable form? ATP. From the organic compounds, the ATP is released by the process of respiration. Unusable energy is converted into usable form by the process of respiration. So respiration make it possible to get the energy, and that energy is required to the day-to-day's life for sitting, standing, speaking, learning, all the life processes which will be occur that need energy, and that energy we get from the process of this respiration. So the respiration is called as the energy giving life process. So this respiration has an equation. One of the equation I want to write here, that is, we'll take example of energy giving food is the carbohydrate. Glucose, carbohydrate simple form glucose, we'll take here C6H12O6 is the glucose organic compound. When it gets oxidized, so addition of oxygen, and which gives rise to 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP molecules of energy will be released. Here only one glucose molecule, only one glucose molecule is giving the 38 ATP molecules of energy. And the byproducts of this equation are the oxygen and carbon dioxide. These two are the byproducts. Those are released how? And the energy which is there, 38 ATP energy, some of the energy will be stored and some energy will be released in the form of a heat. कुछ एनर्जी हीट के फॉर्म में बाहर निकल जाती है और जो बची हुई एनर्जी है वो बॉडी में क्या होती है, स्टोर हो जाती है. और ये दो CO2 और H2O दोस विल बी रिलीज्ड आउट. वाटर वेपर जो है, व्हेन वी विल बी एक्सहेल, व्हेन वी रिलीज द एयर आउट, एट दैट टाइम द कंटेंट ऑफ द CO2 एंड वाटर वेपर विल बी रिलीज्ड. एंड सो दिस ग्लूकोज विल गेट ऑक्सीडाइज्ड, सो इट गिव्स आउट द 38 ATP molecules of energy. This is the equation of respiration. And for this, the process of gaseous exchange takes place. Gaseous exchange will be takes place between the organisms and environment. ये वो तो कहाँ से आया? Environments. और ये glucose कहाँ है? Body में. ये organism के अंदर है. This is present in the organism. And O2 comes from the environment. O2 comes from the environment. And CO2 and water vapors will be released into the environment. And this ATP, 38 ATP molecules of energy is released into the organism. So the exchange of gases will be takes place in between the organisms and the environment. Environment or organism ke बीच में एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस होता है. एंड द साइट ऑफ गैसेस एक्सचेंज इज कॉल्ड द रेस्पिरेटरी सरफेस. रेस्पिरेटरी सरफेस किसको कहते हैं? व्हाट इज रेस्पिरेटरी सरफेस? रेस्पिरेटरी सरफेस मीन्स व्हाट? द साइट ऑफ गैसेस एक्सचेंज, वेयर डज इट ऑकर्स. ये साइट कहां पर, ये प्लेस जहां पर गैसेस एक्सचेंज होते हैं उसी को क्या कहते हैं? द गैसेस एक्सचेंज विल बी ऑकर्स. द साइट ऑफ गैसेस एक्सचेंज इज कॉल्ड एज द रेस्पिरेटरी सरफेस. सो
exit easily. That's what it has to be.
to be highly vascular. Highly vascular का मीनिंग क्या होता है इधर? Highly vascular means it has to be high supply of blood vessels. ज्यादा अगर ब्लड वेसल रहेंगे तो ब्लड की इधर क्या हो जाएगा? ज्यादा हो जाएगा. ब्लड अगर ज्यादा है तो एक चिंतक कैपेसिटी ज्यादा होती है. सो इट हैज टू बी हाईली वेस्क्यूलर एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इट हैज टू बी द परमिएबल. परमिएबल परमिएबल मीन्स इट कैन परमिट द गैसेस इजीली और इट अलाउ द गैसेस टू एक्सचेंज इजीली फ्रॉम इन एंड आउट. सो first of all the area has to be large and second thing it has to be thin the respiratory surface area and it has to be highly vascular and apart from that it should be permeable it allow the gases to exchange easily then it has to be moist so here we have to be remember the points regarding the surface respiratory surface respiratory surface kya hai it is the site of gases exchange is called as respiratory surface and to the efficient gases exchange the respiratory surface area should have the following features first one is it is has to be large area and second one it should be thin then it should be highly vascular next it has to be permeable then it should be moist these qualities that respiratory surface area should be have then the efficient gases of exchange will be takes place this is regarding the respiratory exchange gases exchange in plants in the plants gases exchange will be takes place by the process of diffusion by the process of diffusion diffusion means what here diffusion is nothing but the movement of molecules from high grade of concentration to the low grade of concentration high grade of concentration to the low grade of concentration what are moving those are the moving ions molecules are moving from high grade of concentration to the low grade of concentration is called diffusion अगर जहां पर कोई किसी आयन का अगर कंसंट्रेशन ज्यादा हो गया तो ज्यादा से ही क्या जाए किधर जाएगा ये यहाँ पर कम है वहां पर मूव होता है उसी को कहते हैं डिफ्यूजन सो इन द प्लांट्स गैसेस एक्सचेंज विल बी टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ दिस बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिफ्यूजन सो द इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द गैसेस एक्सचेंज विच इज देयर दैट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द शेप एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्लांट जो कोई भी प्लांट है वो प्लांट का जो शेप है शेप एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्लांट बॉडी इट फैसिलिटेट द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन इट फैसिलिटेट द टाइप ऑफ गैसेस एक्सचेंज सो हियर दिस फॉर आवर सिलेबस थ्री एग्जांपल्स हैव बीन गिवन फर्स्ट वन विच इज देयर दैट इज द टेरेस्ट्रियल फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स इन द टेरेस्ट्रियल फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स so we find here many more small pores will be present on the surface of the leaves those are present on the surface of the leaves and end stem then some of the roots will be find small tiny structures will be present those tiny structures those small pores are called as the stomata so these are the openings small openings are present through this stomata the exchange of gases will be takes place in the terrestrial flowering plants with the help of this stomata so if we take the transverse section of this leaf then we will be find here the upper epidermis this side and lower epidermis so here inside many cells will be present and in between these cells some spaces are present some air spaces are present so this area is vacant the air spaces are present and those are continuously present they allow the oxygen to get inside those allow to get in the oxygen and those will be released out CO2
and water vapors will be released out and water will be get inside this air spaces. In this way, these air spaces will be facilitate the leaves and this end stem and some roots to exchange the gases in terrestrial flowering plants. Then second one which is there, that is aerated soil. Here the plant body is fixed into the soil. It is fixed into the soil and the soil is loose. The air may goes inside the soil. The soil is loose, the air may goes inside. Agar air ja raha hai to wahan par oxygen bhi chala jayega. The oxygen also may goes inside. When it goes inside, the roots which have been fixed here, so there what will be present? There either the soil will be moist. Moisture will be present. Moisture or in this sometimes water. Moisture or water will be present. And this oxygen which is going from the atmosphere to the soil, so that will be dissolved into this water. And the root tissues which are present here, the root tissues will be allow the oxygen to get inside by the process of diffusion. Ab yahan par bahar oxygen ka level zyada ho gaya, oxygen will be more in this aerated area, aerated soil. Then the root tissues which are here present, here the soil is moist and water is present, this oxygen will be get dissolved into that water and this root tissue will be allow that oxygen to get inside this plant body. In this way, in the root tissues also exchange of gases will be takes place. This is the second example has been given in our textbook. Now third one which is there, third example which have been given here, that is the woody flowering plants. Woody flowering plants is ke andar bade trees, trees and shrubs. Trees and shrubs will come inside this woody flowering plants. So these woody flowering plant ka jo bark hota hai, that is impervious. The bark of the woody flowering trees is impervious. Impervious in the sense those don't allow the substances to pass through it. Those are impervious bark. They have and this bark don't allow the substances to pass through it. At that time some cells, small cells will be present on the surface of this bark. Those cells are called as the lenticels. These lenticels will be allow the gases exchange on the bark of this woody flowering plants, trees and shrubs. So this lenticels also will be found on the surface of the mango, on the surface of mango, on the surface of the apple will be found the lenticels, will be present, small cells. Those helps in the exchange of gases. So in this way, gases exchange in the plant body will be takes place by the process of diffusion, and it depend upon the shape and structure of the plant body which will be facilitate the type of respiration. So here the terrestrial flowering plants has the stomatas on the surface of the leaves, end stem and roots, those will be allow the gases exchange. And in the aerated soil, the oxygen will be goes into the film of a moisture, or in the water it will be get dissolved and these root tissues will be diffuse that oxygen inside their body. So in this way, in the aerated soil, gases exchange will be takes place, and in the woody flowering plants, with the help of lenticels, gases exchange will be takes place.
Respiration in animals. As compared to the plants, in the animals, great varieties of respiratory surfaces or organs are present. So here we will be find one chart. So in that chart, one table is there. Here organisms and their habitat and their respiratory surface or organ is given. So the question may be come in the examination like match the following and all. So as the organisms have evolved, same way the respiratory organs also evolved. The chart has been given here. Look at once. First one, the protists or sponges and cylindrates.
those habitat is, they are present in the water, aquatic in habitat, and they will be perform the respiration with the help of the plasma membrane with the body surface area. Those will be respire. So second phylum is Platyhelminthes. The example has been given here, flatworms, Planaria, and in the annelids, earthworm, nereis, leech, in the amphibia, frog. So they are aquatic or semi-aquatic. They may be live in water as well as on the land, amphibians. And plasma membrane, gaseous body, general body surface, moist skin. Those will be respire through this respiratory surfaces. Then the largest phylum, Arthropoda, in that class, Insecta. Those are the habitat is terrestrial. They will be lead their life on the land, and they will be perform the respiration with the help of this tracheal system called spiracles. With the help of the spiracles, those will be perform the respiration. Then arachnids, the spiders and scorpions, they are also terrestrial, and they have the book lungs. So with the help of that book lungs, those will be respire. Next, Limulus is there. Limulus also comes under the Arthropoda. So it is an aquatic animal, and they will be breathed by the book gills. Then amphibians, tadpoles of rock, salamanders and newts. So they are also aquatic, and they will be breathed with the help of this external gills. Then fish. Fishes are also aquatic, and those will be breathed by the internal gills. Amphibians, tadpoles of frog and salamanders and newts has the external gills. Fishes has the internal gills. Then the higher animals like reptile, birds and mammals, those are terrestrial. They will be breathed with the help of the lungs. And as we know that in the higher organisms, the respiratory system and circulatory system are associated. So with the help of these lungs, those will be breathe. Then the turtles, when those are under the water, they will be, during the time of hibernation, those will be breathe with the help of the cloaca. With the cloacal opening, those will be allow the exchange of gases. And the sea turtle which is there, that one will be breathe with the help of the lungs.
So here are the some questions on the first page. Can you recall first one, definition of the respiration? Already we have learned the definition of respiration. It is a biochemical process of oxidation of organic compounds in an orderly manner for the liberation of chemical energy in the form of ATP. In this way, we can give the definition there. Next question, second question is the types of cellular respiration. So there are two types of cellular respiration. First one is the aerobic respiration, and second one is the anaerobic respiration. If the respiration will be takes place with the help of oxygen, is called as aerobic respiration, and if the respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen, is called as anaerobic respiration. So these are the two main types of the respiration. Third question is, why should we respire all the time? Why we need to be respire all the time? Because we need energy all the time, and the respiration stops, we cannot find the energy. So our day to day life will be get stops. That's what we need to be respire all the time. The next question, use your brain power is there below that. What would happen if the respiration takes place in one single step? If the respiration takes place in one single step, so what would be happens there? The energy which is there, that energy is releasing stepwise manner. So if in case the energy is released at a time, then the cell will be get burst. We know that this is one of the cell respiration will be occurs only one glucose molecule. When it is oxidized, it gives 38 ATP molecules of energy. If the single cell, small cell, only one glucose molecule releases 38 ATP molecules of energy at a time, if it is released, then the this cell will be get burst. And the heat energy which is there, heat energy will be released more. The wastage of energy will be occurs there. That is what at a time the respiration will not takes place in single step. Then next question is there, curiosity box. What are the main features of the respiratory surface? Respiratory surface की main function of features क्या है? तो पहला it has to be large area, उसका area जो है वो large होना चाहिए और it has to be thin respiratory surface. Respiratory surface के features क्या है? It has to be large area. Second one it has to be thin and highly vascular and it has to be permeable and it should be moist. These characters should be have the respiratory surface to efficient gases exchange. Next question is, in the curiosity box, which are the parts of the plant help in the process of gases exchange? As we have seen, the stomata in the plants and lenticels and some root tissues will be help in gases exchange in the plants. So these were the questions which has been given in our textbook. We have completed that. Apart from that, if you have any doubt, so those can come up with your doubt. So today will be stop here. Remaining part will be continued in the tomorrow session.
Sampurna.